Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the 50 unit problems from the subject electronic circuits too. So the 50 unit, it is nothing but the power amplifier and DC to DC converter. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the DC to DC converter problems. Okay. So already you know there are three types of DC to DC converter. One is a buck converter, another one is boost converter, then buck boost converter. Okay, buck converter means it is nothing but a step down converter. Step down means the higher DC voltage it can convert into lower DC voltages. For example, 10 volt DC is converted into 5 volt DC. It is called as a buck converter. Okay, similarly, the next converter, it is called as a boost converter. So boost converter means it is a step up converter. It can convert the lower voltages into some higher voltages. For example, the 5 volt, it can be converted into 10 volt. Okay. Similarly, the third type of DC to DC converter, it is a buck boost converter. Okay. So buck boost converter means a step up down converter. The same converter, it can be acting as a step up converter as well as the step down converter. Okay. Depending upon the duty cycle value. So this is called as a buck boost converter. Okay. So in this three converter, we are going to see the problems related with thing. So in order to solve this problem, first you should know the formulas used for the three things. Okay. So first you see, that is in that, what are the thing they are asking means duty cycle, output voltage, then peak to peak ripple current through the inductor, peak to peak ripple voltage across the capacitor. Okay, then the critical value of inductor and critical value of capacitor. So these are all the terms they will ask in a problem. Okay, so that is in this three converter, it consists of one transistor, then one load, okay, one load resistor, then one inductor and one capacitor. It is acting as a filter. Okay, so that's all. So all this circuit consisting of that element only, based on the connection, it will work in different type. Okay, so buck converter, you see, in buck converter, buck means step down converter, boost means step up converter, buck boost means both the thing. Either it can reduce the output or it can increase the output depending upon the thing. Okay, so you know the formula. The output voltage of the step down converter is V naught is equal to alpha into Vs. Okay, where what is alpha means alpha is a duty cycle. Okay, so duty cycle is nothing but it's a ratio of on time divided by the total time. It is said to be the duty cycle. So usually the duty cycle value, this alpha value, it should be less than one. It is a fraction. Okay, so for buck converter, the output voltage is alpha into Vs. Okay, V naught is a output voltage, Vs is a input voltage applied to that converter. Similarly, for boost converter, the output voltage is equal to input voltage divided by 1 minus alpha. Okay, so here duty cycle into input voltage. Here Vs divided by 1 minus alpha. Then in buck boost converter, the output voltage is equal to minus of the input voltage multiplied with alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. So if this alpha value, this duty cycle value is less than 0.5, means it will behave like a buck converter. Okay, if the duty cycle alpha value is greater than 0.5, means it behave like a boost converter. Okay, so this is the output voltage formula for the three things. Okay, so from that, from the output voltage equation, if you are rearranging this duty cycle alpha, we can get the duty cycle for buck converter is V naught by Vs. It's a ratio of output voltage divided by input voltage. This is the duty cycle for buck converter. Similarly, if you are rearranging the formula for this boost converter, so alpha can be, duty cycle is equal to 1 minus Vs divided by V naught. Okay, so this is the duty cycle for boost converter. So you just rearrange from the above formula, you can get the answer. Similarly, if you are rearranging the above equation, we can get the duty cycle is equal to output voltage divided by the difference between the output voltage and input voltage. Okay, so this is said to be the duty cycle for the three converters. Okay, then the next thing, peak to peak ripple current. Okay, peak to peak ripple current through inductor. So in the tree case, we are using the inductor. So the current flowing through that inductor. Okay, the change, what is the maximum rate of change of current flowing through the inductor? That formula, it is a del I. Okay, so the del I is equal to for a buck converter, 1 minus alpha into alpha Vs divided by F into L, where L is a inductor value, F is the frequency. Okay, alpha is a duty cycle, Vs is the input voltage. Then for a boost converter, del I is equal to alpha Vs divided by FL. Okay, so this formula, okay, except this 1 minus alpha in boost converter, the remaining term, okay, except this 1 minus alpha, alpha Vs divided by F into L is the ripple current through the for boost converter, as well as for buck boost converter also the same del I. Okay, so this del I formula is remain same for this boost converter as well as the buck boost converter. Okay, and the next thing, peak to peak ripple voltage across the capacitor. Okay, so voltage across the capacitor, it is del VC. So the del VC formula is del I divided by 8F into C. Okay, so this is the del VC formula. And for this boost converter, what is the formula? Means I naught into alpha divided by F into C. Okay, where I naught is the output current flowing through the load. Okay, the load current, alpha is a duty cycle, F is the frequency, C is the capacitor. And for boost converter also, the del VC remains same, I naught alpha divided by FC. Okay, so the del I value and del VC value remain same for boost converter and buck boost converter. Okay, then the next thing, the critical value of inductor. Okay, so what is the maximum value of that inductor? That the critical value of inductor L is nothing but 1 minus alpha R divided by 2F. Similarly, for boost converter, alpha into 1 minus alpha R divided by 2F. Okay, so in the same formula, you just multiply 1 alpha. Okay, similarly for a buck boost converter, LC is equal to 1 minus alpha R by 2F. So for buck converter and buck boost converter, the LC formula remains same. Okay, then the critical value of capacitor is for a buck converter, 1 minus alpha by 16 LF squared. For boost converter, alpha by 2FR. Similarly, for a buck boost converter also, the formula remains same, alpha by 2FR. Okay, so the ripple current, ripple voltage across the capacitor and critical value of capacitor, this three formula remains same for boost converter and buck boost converter. Okay, and the remaining thing, it will vary in some 1-1 quantity. Okay, so in order to solve this problem, first you should know this formulas. Okay, so you just note down this formula in your notebook. So then only you can calculate in an easy manner. Okay, so now using this, we are going to solve the problem. So the first problem you see, okay, so the first problem is related with the buck converter. So you see the first question, a buck converter has an input voltage of 15 volt, okay, and required output voltage is 6 volt. At R equal to 200 ohm. Okay, load, the resistance is load resistance 200 ohm. And the peak to peak ripple voltage is 20 millivolt. So peak to peak ripple voltage means del VC. If it is operating at 20 gigahertz, so operating frequency F is 20 kilohertz, and peak to peak ripple current of inductor is 0.8 amps, determine the following. So what are the data they are asking? Means one is duty cycle, filter inductance and capacitance value, then critical value of inductor and capacitor. So the three data we have to find out. Okay, so for buck converter, okay, for buck converter, the input is given, input is 15 volt. Okay, so Vs equal to 15 volt, the required output voltage is 6 volt. So you see, first you note down the data, input is 15 volt, output is 6 volt, and the load resistance is 200 ohm. Then peak to peak voltage, del VC is 20 millivolt. then the frequency is 20 kilohertz. Then peak to peak ripple current is 0.8 amps. Okay, so these are all the given data. So from that, we have to find the three data: duty cycle ratio, inductance and capacitance value, and the critical value of inductance and capacitance value. So first one, duty cycle. So in order to find out the duty cycle, so you know the output equation, output voltage formula for buck converter. So for buck converter, the output voltage V naught is equal to alpha into Vs. Okay, you know. So in this equation, V naught is given, Vs is given. So from that, you just rearrange the duty cycle alpha. So alpha equal to V naught by Vs. Okay, so what is our desired output? The output voltage is 6 volt, input voltage is 15 volt. So 6 by 15.4. Okay, so already you know the duty cycle, it's a fraction. The duty cycle value is always less than 1. So you see alpha equal to 0.4. So if you want to mention the duty cycle in percentage, means you just multiply with 100. So 0.4 into 100, it is a 40%. Okay, so the first question is calculated. Then the second question, we have to find out the filter inductance value and capacitance value. Okay, so in order to find out this inductance and capacitance value, so what are the data given, means R is given, del VC given, and del I given. Okay, so already you know the formula for del VC and del I. So using this del VC formula, you just calculate the capacitor value. Using the del I formula, you just find the inductor value. Okay, so first one, we are taking the peak to peak ripple current of inductor, del I. Okay, so you know the del I formula. Okay, so already this del I formula is given in the first comparison table. So for a buck converter, the del I is equal to 1 minus alpha into alpha Vs by FL. So here alpha, already you know, input voltage, you know, this inductance value, we didn't know, frequency, you know, del I value, you know. So from this, our aim is to find out the inductor. Okay, so if you are rearranging this formula, so the inductor L equal to 1 minus alpha, alpha Vs by F into del I. Okay, so you substitute all values. So 1 minus, what is alpha? Alpha is 0.4 into 0.4 into input voltage. What is the input voltage? 15. Okay, so you substitute 15 divided by, what is the operating frequency? 20 kilohertz. Into what is del I? Del I is given. Okay, in the problem, del I is given as 0.8 amps. So 0.8. So you substitute. Okay, so using CalC, you just calculate the answer. So the answer, you may get 2.25 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, what is the unit? This is the inductor. So unit is Henry. So always we have to mention in engineering term. So 10 to the power minus 4 is not an engineering quantity. So you can convert into either micro or milli. Okay, if you are converting into micro, means you can get 225 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, so the answer is 225 micro Henry. So the inductance value is calculated as 225 micro Henry. Okay, so similarly, using the formula for del VC. Okay, so already you know the formula for peak to peak ripple voltage. So what is the formula for peak to peak ripple voltage? Del VC equal to del I by 8 F into C. Okay, in that del VC, you know, del I, you know, then F, you know, so C only we have to calculate. So you rearrange this formula. So after rearranging, we can get the capacitor C equal to del I divided by 8 F del VC. Okay, so what is del I? 0.8. divided by 8 into frequency is 20 kilohertz. What is del VC? Del VC is given. Okay, 20 millivolt. So 20 into milli, 10 to the power minus 3. So here 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power minus 3 cancel. Then you find out the answer. So you may get 250 microfarad. Okay, so the capacitance value is calculated. So the inductance value and the capacitance value is calculated. Okay, and the next thing, the third thing is to, we have to find out the critical value of inductor and capacitor. Okay, so what is the maximum value of inductor and capacitor? We have to use it. That is a critical value. So the critical value of inductor formula, you know, for buck converter. So the critical value formula is LC equal to 1 minus alpha R by 2F. Okay, so in that all values, you know. So 1 minus alpha, what is the duty cycle? 0.4. And what is the resistance value? 200 ohms divided by 2 into what is the frequency? 20 kilohertz. So you just substitute and find out the answer. It's a 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 Henry. So 3 millihenry. Okay. So this is the critical value of inductor to be used in buck converter. Okay. Then the next one, critical value of capacitor. So the critical value of capacitor is 1 minus alpha by 16 L F squared. Okay, so this is the formula. So again, you substitute all the values. So 1 minus 0.4 by 16. Inductor is, okay, the inductor value. So in this, you just substitute the which inductor value means critical inductance value. Okay, so you can't substitute this ordinary filter capacitance inductor value. While calculating the critical value of capacitor, you substitute this critical inductance in the place of this L. So 3 milli, 10 to the power minus 3 into F squared. So 20 into 10 to the power 3, the whole squared. Okay, so you can get 31.25 nanofarad. So this is the critical value of capacitor. Okay, so all the three values calculated using this. Okay, so now you see, so the first one, duty cycle calculated using the output equation. Then filter inductance and capacitance value calculated. Then the third one is critical value of inductor and capacitance is calculated. So this problem, this is the for buck converter. Similarly, we are going to solve it for boost converter. Okay, so a boost converter, you see the second question, a boost converter has input voltage 5 volt, required output voltage 15 volt at 25 kilohertz. Okay, frequency. When L equal to 150 microhenry, C equal to 220 microfarad, and average load current is 0.5 amps. Okay, so in this boost converter, the different data given. Okay, input given, output given, the value of inductor and capacitor is given. Okay, in the previous problem, input, output, frequency, load resistance given, then a ripple current, ripple voltage given, but here the inductor and capacitance value given. Okay, we have to find the ripple current through inductor and ripple voltage across the capacitor. Okay, so determine duty cycle, peak to peak ripple current. Peak to peak ripple current means del I. Okay, similarly, peak to peak ripple voltage, it is a del VC. Then critical value of L and C. Okay, so we have to find out. So here, which type of converter is given? Boost converter. Okay, so first you note down the given data. So for boost converter, input voltage is 5 volt, output voltage is 15 volt. Then the frequency is 25 kilohertz. Okay. Then the inductor value is 150 microhenry, capacitance is 220 microfarad, average load current is 0.5. Load current means I naught. Okay, load current is I naught 0.5 amps. These are all the given data. So the first question, we have to find out duty cycle. So the duty cycle is calculated from the output voltage formula. So you know, the output voltage for boost converter is V naught equal to Vs by 1 minus alpha, where Vs is a input voltage, alpha is a duty cycle. Okay, so using this equation, you just rearrange this alpha. So this 1 minus alpha you give here, V naught you give here. So 1 minus alpha equal to Vs by V naught. Okay, so from that alpha can be written as 1 minus Vs divided by V naught. So 1 minus, what is input voltage? 5. What is the output? 15. Okay, so the 5 volt can be converted into 15 volt using this boost converter. So you just find the answer. It is a 0.6667. Okay, so this is the duty cycle. So you see the duty cycle value, always it should be less than 1 for any type of converter. Okay, so the duty cycle is calculated. Then the second question is, so if you want to mention in percentage means, you just multiply with 100. So 0.6667 into 100 means 66.67%. Okay, then the second question, peak to peak ripple current through inductor. So for a boost converter, so you know the formula for a peak to peak ripple current. So what is a peak to peak ripple current? The peak to peak ripple current is nothing but del I is equal to alpha Vs divided by F into L. Okay, so what is the alpha value just now calculated? So this alpha, you just substitute in this fraction, not in percentage. Okay, so 0. 667 into the input voltage is 5 volt divided by the frequency. What is the operating frequency? 25 kilo into L. What is the inductor value? Inductor value given in our problem itself, it is given 150 micro. So 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, so you calculate. So the answer is 0.889 amps. Okay, so the del I calculated. Then the third question is peak to peak ripple voltage, del VC. So you know the formula for del VC. So del VC equal to I naught alpha by F into C, where alpha is a duty cycle, I naught is the load current. Load current is also given in our problem. Frequency given, capacitance value is given. So you just substitute. So I naught is 0.5 amps. Okay. Then alpha is 0.667. Then divided by F is 25 kilo into the capacitor is 220 micro. So 220 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay. So you just calculate. So the answer is 0.0606. Okay. So you convert in engineering quantity. So it can be written as 60.6 into 10 to the power minus 3. So millivolt. So 60.6 millivolt is the answer. Okay. Similarly, the fourth question, we have to find the critical value of inductor and capacitor. Okay. So the critical value of inductor and capacitor formula, you know, the critical value of inductor for boost converter is alpha into 1 minus alpha into R divided by 2F. Okay. This is the critical value of inductor. In that alpha, you know, F, you know, but R, the R value is not given in our problem. So we have to find out the load resistance. So first one, you just calculate the load resistance. So the load resistance is nothing but the load voltage divided by load current. That is, load voltage means here output voltage. So it's a ratio of output voltage divided by output current. So what is the output voltage given in our problem? 15 volt. The output current, load current is also given. It is a 0.5. So 15 divided by 0.5, 30 ohms. Okay. So once you calculated this R value, you substitute in this formula. So 0.667 into 1 minus 0.667 into R is 30 divided by 2 into the frequency 25 into 10 to the power 3. Okay, so if you are calculating, it is 133.26 micro henry. Okay, this is the inductor, critical inductor value. Okay, then similarly, you just find the critical value of capacitor. So the critical value of capacitor formula is for boost converter and buck boost converter remains same, alpha by 2FR. Okay, so that's all. So you substitute alpha, frequency and resistance value. So the answer is 0.44 microfarad. Okay, so this is a one type of problem. This is the boost converter. Okay, so for boost converter here, that is what are the data given? Inductor, capacitor value, then input voltage, output voltage, operating frequency and load current is given. So we calculated a duty cycle, del I, del VC and value of critical value of inductor and capacitor. Okay, so similarly, the third problem, buck boost converter, we are going to solve. So you see the third problem, a buck boost converter has input voltage 15 volt. Duty cycle 0.3. So here duty cycle is given. In first two problem, input and output voltage is given. We calculated the duty cycle, but in this problem, in the third problem, input voltage given, output voltage is not at all given, but duty cycle is given. Okay. And operating frequency 20 kilohertz. When inductor value given, capacitor value given, and average load current is given. Load current means I naught is given. So determine the following. Okay, first one is output voltage. So we have to find out output voltage. And second one is peak to peak ripple voltage, del VC. Okay, del VC. Then peak to peak ripple current, del I. Okay, then the next one is critical value of inductor and capacitor. So these four data we have to find out. Okay, so this is somewhat a different problem. So you see, input voltage 15 volt. Duty cycle 0.3. So already if the duty cycle in buck boost converter means it can be acting as a boost converter as well as buck converter depending upon the duty cycle. if the duty cycle less than 0.5 means it can act as a step down converter, that is buck converter. If alpha value greater than 0.5 means it will act as a boost converter. Okay, so here what is the alpha value? 0.3. So it satisfies the first condition. So this buck boost converter, it can act as a step down converter. So the 15 volt input voltage, it is reduced to some value. Okay, so that is the thing. You remember? What are the remaining data given? Alpha given, input voltage given, frequency given, inductance value, capacitance value, and the load current I naught is given. Okay, so what is the first question? Output voltage we have to measure. Okay, so already we know the formula for output voltage. So for buck boost converter, what is the output voltage? The output voltage V naught is equal to minus Vs into alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. Why this minus means in buck boost converter, load is connected in reverse. Okay, so output voltage is negative of the input voltage. So minus Vs alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. So this is the formula for buck boost converter. So you substitute the value. What is Vs? 15 volt. What is alpha? 0.3 divided by 1 minus 0.3. So we can get minus 6.428 volt. So the 15 volt input. So you see the 15 volt input is reduced to 6.428 volt. So this is the step down. Okay. This buck boost converter is acting as a buck converter since alpha is less than 0.5. Okay. Then the next question. Peak to peak ripple voltage. So what is the peak to peak ripple voltage for buck boost converter? So del Vc equal to I naught alpha by Fc. I naught is the load current. Load current given 1.5 amps into alpha 0.3 divided by frequency of 20 kilohertz into the capacitor. Capacitor value, you see, capacitor is 250 micro. Okay, so 250 micro. Micro means 10 to the power minus 6. So 250 into 10 to the power minus 6. So you substitute and find out the answer 0.09 volt. So you convert into engineering quantity. It is a 90 millivolt. So Vc, peak to peak ripple voltage is 90 millivolt. Okay. Then the next one, peak to peak ripple current. So the ripple current is del I. So del I is equal to alpha Vs divided by F into L. Okay. So where alpha is 0.3. Input voltage is 15 divided by F is 20 kilohertz and L is 300 micro, 300 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, so the answer is 0.75 amps. So peak to peak ripple current calculated. And the third question is we have to find critical value of L and C. So what is the critical value of inductor in buck boost converter? 1 minus alpha R by 2F. Okay, so you substitute all values. R here, the load resistance R is not at all given in our problem. Okay, so you just calculate the load resistance value. So load resistance is nothing but minus of the ratio of output voltage divided by input output current. Okay, so minus of what is the V naught value? The V naught just now we calculated minus 6.428. So minus of minus plus. So 6.428 divided by 1.5. So 4.285 ohms. Okay, so you can substitute the values. So you can get a 74.98 microhenry. Okay, similarly, the critical value of capacitor is given by the capacitor value is equal to alpha by 2FR. Okay, so you substitute the thing, you may get 1.75 microfarad. Okay, so we calculated all the answers. Okay, so similar to this. Okay, so in this video, we discussed the three problems. One is related with the buck converter and another one is related with the boost converter and the third one is a buck boost converter. Okay, so in this thing, that is some data. If input voltage, output voltage, you know means you may calculate duty cycle. If input voltage, duty cycle, you know means we can calculate the output voltage. Okay, and as well as if inductor capacitor value given means we may calculate del I and del Vc. Okay, similarly, del I, del Vc given means we can rearrange the formula, we can calculate L and C value. Okay, and the critical value of inductor and capacitor value we can find out. Okay, so in order to solve this problem, first you should know this table. Okay, so the values. Okay, what are the formula used in order to calculate this problem? Okay, so you note down this table, this comparison of this DC to DC converter and the formula used in your notebook. So then only you can solve. Okay, so in this, so this is a big question. If the 2-mark question they will ask means only they will ask to calculate only duty cycle. If it is a 1-2 mark question, then using the data you may calculate a ripple current or a critical value of inductor, critical value of capacitors. Individually asking means it is a 2-mark question. Okay, so if all data we are calculating means it is a big question. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn, so already I posted for 5 units the MCQ questions for this electronic circuit subject. It's already posted. Okay, so that all videos are available in my channel in the name of in the playlist in the name of electronic circuits to MCQ. Okay, so in that the 1-mark question as well as the 2-mark problems. Okay, so the 2-mark and 4-mark problem is also solved in that. Okay, so if you want to learn, you learn that. I will give link for those videos in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will see in the next video with some other problems.